We have incredible soils. We have good soils. We have wonderful variety of topographies. So we have slopes in many different directions, which means that for many different wine varieties, we can plant on these different slopes. So the new areas that we can explore offer us many diverse opportunities. The other areas we are exploring already are up the west coast. There, the cooling influence of the sea is huge.
So it's off to the west coast then. The R27 takes you in a long straight line to the town of Darling, which is where we're going to discover the unusual bush vines. These are low-hanging vines with wide foliage that protects them from the sun and the harsh wind of the sea. The R27 travels along the West Coast National Park, a feast for nature lovers. The straight road goes as far as what is known as Swartland, in the west of the Cape Province. And it's in Darling you can find the wine estate of Kloof. They produce their wine from the grapes of the bush vines, and not surprisingly, their wine is called bush wine. In recent years, excellent and unusual wines have surfaced on a regular basis in the region around Darling. Slowly but surely, the region's specific character became a talking point, to such an extent that people started talking about a new Cape terroir. The bush vines are free-growing vines whose roots bore deep into the subsoil for purchase and go in search of life-giving moisture. They have a relatively low yield that heightens the concentration of taste and aroma in the grapes. The Kloof Wine Estate produces a tasty bush wine from these vines, a typical South African terroir wine.